from Mother Earth's vulva, and they would have sacrifices that put them in the vault.
East is east and west is west, and the wrong one I have chose. Let's go where I'll keep on wearing those frills and flowers and buttons and bows, rings and things and
I had just turned seven, but my mother took me away from a jolly, jazz-loving father, status in society, and a secure home near the beach in Kitsilano to live in Penticton, residing in motels and cheap apartments. She was chasing down my future stepfather, and I was like the goat, tied to the back of the cart to be milked for sympathy from the relatives and friends when needed. My mother hated radios and record players, so instead of the Mills Brothers and Nat King Cole, I was exposed to endless screaming tirades. You know, like the mother's screaming fit in Alfred Hitchcock's The Birds, that would continue on after I went to bed, and my prayers would consist of, "Please God, make mommy stop screaming at me," repeated like a mantra until I could fall asleep. God never answered my prayers. School, which up to then had been a joyous experience, instead became another version of hell. The small town mothers told their children not to play with me, as I was my mother's daughter, the divorcee. The bullying approved of by my disapproving teacher, adding her discouragement of my academic efforts. I don't want to tell the whole life of misery with my mother, but to explain what happened. I never saw my dad at all, and this miserable Christmas, for Christmas decorations, I cut the camels and the oasis out of the camel cigarette packages and glued them to the window with the condensation from the air. I was told to accept this other strange man into my life as my father, and whose presence was the only respite from my mother's screaming. I think most of the light went out of my soul. I decided I had to get tough. I wasn't loved by anyone, so my seven-year-old self decided that if I could conquer the elements, I could have some control over my life. I actually thought this. I went outside without my coat one day in January with my bike, the only thing I had left from my dad, and rode around in circles in the motel lot until I couldn't feel anything. When I went inside, my mother took one look at me and started screaming again. Only this time, it was about the fact that I had turned blue, and she, still giving me shit, ran a hot bath and put me in. But by then, I was losing consciousness. Ever after, whenever I get into a hot bath after being very chilled, my body shoots me right back to that time. But it wasn't until the day of the march that I understood what it was I was experiencing. The march on Valentine's Day was sunny, but cold. We sweated. The Japanese hall was unheated when we sat for the feast. Later at home, I was getting ready to go out again, and I realized that I needed to take a hot bath to warm up. When I got in the bath, I received a double experience, one that made me understand something I had not connected before. It was only because of my own history that I had a better understanding of how this process of low self-esteem and environmental factors work together to produce the death and suffering for these women to care so little about themselves, but at the same time have such compassion and understanding for each other.